All right, for this example, we're going to try to evaluate the limit as x approaches 4 for the function the square root of x minus 2 divided by x minus 4. Now, sometimes we get lucky and we can take this value here and we can plug it in to the expression here. And as long as this function is continuous at this value, then the limit will match what the function value is. And so that's very nice. But what we notice for this example, as with a lot of these limit examples, is when you try to take 4 and plug it in, you actually get 0 over 0. And that's what we call an indeterminate form. Now, what do we do in this type of situation? Well, the one thing that needs to be stressed about limits is technically a limit does not care what happens at x equals c. So even though it's undefined or it's indeterminate at x equals 4, the limit could very well still exist. There's plenty of cases where you've got examples of something where the function value is not defined at a point, but the limit would still exist there. So we're not going to give up on this guy quite yet. And there are other ways we can evaluate this limit. Now, the way I'm going to do in this video is evaluate it numerically. There are other ways to evaluate this limit, like analytically or graphically. But the way we're going to practice for this example is we're going to do it numerically. And what numerically means is we're going to use a table. Now, I went ahead and took my TI here, and you could technically do this without the calculator. It would just be a little quicker to chew through the algebra with the calculator here. So I went ahead and typed this function in y equals, you see right here. And then if you go to second table set, you can set the table as to where you want to start it and how wide you want the units to be, how far apart your x values need to be in your table. So we'll start this value at 4. And if you want it to automatically generate the table, you can set this delta table, or that in essence, that's the table width. That's what delta means, is the change in, to be 0.1. And if we automatically let it generate the x values, because x is the independent variable and y is the dependent variable because y depends on x, then it'll automatically spit out the x and y values for the whole function. So if we go to second table right here, you'll see it just plows through everything. And I'll actually back up a little bit. And you can see something here. Do you see right here at 4, there's an error, right? Because if you tried to plug in 4, the point was undefined at 4. But if you look from the left and right side of 4, 0.25487, 0.25321, 0.25158, skip over 4, 0.24846, 0.24695, 0.24548. It looks like from both sides of 4, if you look on both sides, it looks like it's going to 0.25, right? That's the way it appears. And in fact, that's the case. Now, if you're not convinced, if you're not totally sure about that, what you could always do is go back in the table set and pick a smaller width, like maybe 0.01, you know, or something like that. And you'll notice that it'll zoom in even closer to 4. And go to the table then. Oops, it changed my starting value. Let's start at 4 again. Okay, and sure enough, if you look around 4, now it's even more clear. 0.249 and 0.2501. Seems very clear that it's going to 0.25. So that's how we can determine limits, even if we have an indeterminate point at whatever x equals c is. So I'll go back up here. Here's our table. I'll blow it up a little bit. Okay, and it should be pretty clear that the limit would be 0.25 or 1/4. Now I'll tell you one other thing. If you have random x values that you want to try, you don't want it to automatically generate them for you, you can set your table to make it ask you for the x values. And then I would always let it automatically generate the y values, but make it ask you for the x values. That way you can go in and manually type in what's 3.9. Enter, and it'll tell you what's 3.99. And then let it tell you. You see, and so you can manually make up your own table if that's what you want to do.